as we're fast discovering on this essential Japan journey, this is a country full of contradictions. And on this trip, Scenic makes sure we experience them all. So after a jaunt through the countryside, we're back in the big smoke of Nagoya. The fourth largest city in the country is home to a couple of its major attractions, including one of Japan's largest castles. Nagoya Castle was almost entirely destroyed in World War II, with only a few of its original turrets remaining. The main keep was reconstructed in the 1950s and now contains a museum of the castle's history.
So this gives us a great idea of how Nagoya Castle was built.
I know, you know, how to really pull the huge stones.
It would have taken thousands of people.
Oh, yeah.
All right, let's see if I've got it.
Okay.
I bet they didn't have to do it in high heels, though, huh?
From Nagoya, we're headed southwest to the charming city of Kyoto, the former imperial capital of the country for over 1,000 years. Despite its population, this is a very easy country to get around, thanks to its fast and super efficient public transport system.
We're now travelling to Kyoto on the Shinkansen, or the bullet train, which travels at up to 300 kilometres an hour, which turns a 2.5-hour car trip into a blurringly fast 30-minute trip on the train.
After just enough time to take in the scenery whizzing past, we've arrived in the ancient city of Kyoto.
Kyoto was once the capital of Japan for over 1,000 years, a place where Buddhist priests built shrines and temples and emperors built palaces. All came with gardens, making Kyoto, still to this day, one of Japan's most beautiful cities.
Owing to its glory days as the ancient capital, Kyoto is a city steeped in tradition.
Momo, this is so peaceful.
Yes. So this path is called the Philosopher's Path, and one of the famous Japanese philosopher, and he was a professor of Kyoto University, he used this path for daily walk.
And would think about life.
Yes. Oh. So he was meditating while he was walking.
How long is the Philosopher's Path?
This is about 2 kilometers long.
Kyoto is a lovely place for a stroll, and this here is one of its best. Lined with trees and following a canal, it's hard not to embrace the path's purpose.
I like how each step is its own stone, so you really have to focus on where you're going. So it's a lot of mindfulness.
Yes, and this is tell you to slow down your speed.
I feel like I've just had an epiphany. Stop rushing. I love it. Because the only thing that's rushing around here is the river.
Yes.
Momo, we found Zen. It's here in Kyoto.
Kyoto is home to many ancient Japanese traditions, and foremost is the tea ceremony.
Konnichiwa.
Konnichiwa.
The ritual evolved many centuries ago at a time when dressing in a kimono was standard daily practice.
So I've chosen a kimono to put on for the tea ceremony, but this is secret women's business, excuse us. Konnichiwa. There's about 7 layers underneath this kimono. I can hardly breathe. Oh, konnichiwa, everybody!
While it's not a religious ceremony, it's heavily influenced by Zen Buddhism. So this is a very peaceful and polite experience, almost like a choreographed performance.
Today, I'd like to show you how to drink tea with good manners.
I love tea. I start the day with tea. I finish the day with tea. But the Japanese, they take it to a whole new level.
The tea ceremony and kimono wearing is one of Scenic's enrich experiences. Unique events exclusively organised for us lucky Scenic guests.